Try and picture a farm. This is probably what comes to mind. Vast rolling fields, greenery, peace, and tranquility. Or think of farms in our video games, our commercials. You probably find a lot of smiling animals, red tractors, and soothing pastoral scenes. But this is what a farm actually looks like. The way we grow our food is, let's face it, ugly. When we first started farming, some 12,000 years ago, agriculture was a revolution. It signaled the birth of a civilization. But now, well, let's just say, it's causing a lot of damage. And some of that damage is invisible, but deadly. Meet methane, a byproduct of farming. It's quickly cranking up the temperature of our fast-warming planet.
Methane, a greenhouse gas that's second only to carbon dioxide in driving global warming.
Scientists say this has been responsible for about half the human-induced warming of the planet we've experienced so far.
If we want to continue feeding a growing population, we need to rethink this system. Maybe it's time for another agricultural revolution, one that will transform how we think about what we eat, because the real cost we're paying for food is more than we can afford. In our quest to find food, we're devouring the planet. Mass farming is the new ugly face of an industry as old as our civilization. The process of growing crops and livestock is chipping away at the environment in a lot of different ways. We're cutting down trees to make room for cattle and growing crops. We're using pesticides that degrade the soil and reduce its quality. And we're using water, a lot of water, to irrigate crops. We're operating at a loss across everything. And these are not even the biggest problems we face, because while we're literally eating our way through the only planet we have, tons of greenhouse gases are ending up in the air as a result. One of those is methane, that potent gas that, yes, let's just get it out of our system, can come from farting. What is a video about climate without a little bit of toilet humor? Methane is about 80 times more potent than CO2, with a much shorter lifespan. Once it's in the air, it doesn't take long to start raising the temperature. For instance, rice cultivation alone is responsible for 8% of human-caused methane emissions, but the overwhelming majority of it comes from livestock and animal farming. Our beef craze is responsible for about 40% of global methane emissions. One cow emits a staggering 220 pounds of methane every year. And as of this year, there are about 1 billion cows in the world. That is a lot of methane. Clearly, we have to do something. Our current industrial system exploits and does not restore. It uses up resources and does a lot of damage to the soil and land. Reversing this is what regenerative agriculture is all about. It's a type of farming that centers the health of the environment and actively restores it in the process. A way of growing food that uses as many different parts of nature holistically without disturbing or damaging any of it. So how do we set up this new system? Well, for starters, it's not actually new. We've been doing things like this since way back when we started farming. It's time to go back to our roots. Is that a pun? Pun intended. Look at this wildly simple solution for a very problematic kind of farming, rice cultivation. Rice is the most consumed food crop around the world. It's a great source of calories, especially in low and middle income countries, but it's also a great source of methane. Enter ducks. Ducks are the superstars of a farming system that has ancient roots in Japan. By letting them loose on rice crops, they feed on pests, eliminating the need for pesticides. They poop everywhere and enrich the land. And they move soil around with their beaks, allowing oxygen to oxidize the methane and stop it from getting into the atmosphere. This farming style is now used not only in Japan, but also China and France and Iran and various other countries around the world. There are a lot of other simple techniques that solve other farming problems too. For example, in Colombia, a World Bank-led project planted more than 2.6 million trees from 80 different species between 2010 and 2019. And it wasn't just to reforest the land, but to be used for something else as well. These trees provided shade to animals in agriculture farms. It protected them from the heat, which reduced their stress levels. It also provided richer ecosystems for other plants to grow, restoring biodiversity in the area and giving the cows a much better diet. Less stress equals less farts, just like humans. Is that even a thing? Not only do these techniques help reduce methane emissions, they can also improve an ecosystem's ability to absorb carbon. According to the World Bank, this project stored more than 1.2 million tons of carbon. who knew that throwing some shade could be good for the planet? But of course, that alone isn't going to save us. There are tons of examples of regenerative farming, but they all have one thing in common. They require us to rethink our practices and reevaluate our consumption habits. Because regenerative agriculture is about observing the environment and finding creative ways for its different elements to work together. This is how nature works to begin with. We just need to tune in and use what we already have without exploiting it. Paying attention to methane is more urgent than it's ever been, because unfortunately, it's a lot worse than we thought. Reducing it is not optional anymore, but that's why regenerative agriculture is such an important part of the puzzle. As we look to the future, it can help us restore our planet whilst feeding a growing population. And in the short term, in the face of this great crisis, it can help us reduce global warming right now.